Thank you. have your church to love you with the plan to be done church through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is the best with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Kings. Elijah went a day's journey into
this fury, anger, shouting, and reviling must be removed from you, along with all malice. And be kind to one another, compassionate, forgiving one another as God has forgiven you in Christ. So be imitators of God and beloved children, and live in love as Christ loved us and handed himself over for us as a sacrificial offering to God for a fragrant aroma. The word of the Lord.
The guest of honor on the day, My brother priests around here, the pastor, the deacons, religious men and women in their faith. I am very honored to stand before you and share the word of God's giving on the silver jubilee of our brother Father Deo. I know part of his family is also here with us. We are so grateful to them for having given them to the apostle Jesus to be a priest in the church. Coming all the way from northwest of Tanzania is a far away distance, if you can imagine. But he has accepted willingly to serve as a priest. I was very fortunate to be a servant during the day of their commission
in 1997 January. And I remember very well, I hope he remembers too, the word of the Spirit General who commissioned them on that day in our shrine in Nairobi. And this is what he said, and I quote, "As you go to the mission, remember that we are sending you as apostles of Jesus, missionaries for Africa and the world. Make sure you serve the people of God and trust it to your care with the same zeal like that of the early church members. Your whole priesthood must be rooted in the Eucharist and fervent prayer life." 25 years later, I can tell that our brother Father Deo has lived to the expectation of the Spirit General who commissioned them to go into the field and serve. So as we reflect in the context of his 25 years, I would like us to look into three things. One, the prophetic ministry. Two, the kingly ministry. And three, the priestly ministry that he has expressed and he shared with all the people where he has been working. There, we want to thank you for always preaching the word of God with such enthusiasm. Because we work together in the council, sometimes I call Dale late in the evening, and he could tell me, say, "Father, can I call you back after 20 minutes? I said, "Dale, what are you doing?" "I'm preparing my homily, Father." It's just because he knows what it means to prepare homily so as to nourish the people of God. People are hungry for the word of God, and he knows that. That's why he takes his own time to prepare his own homily. And I know very many of you have been sharing with some of us how wonderful his homilies have been here. That is the work of a prophet. He is to nourish you with the word of God. And today here, we are thanking God for him, for having been ready to prepare and spend more time in making this homily a wonderful homily, so that everybody will be nourished. You see how the people were looking for Jesus because they're so hungry. And it's only the word of God that can quench their thirst and give them hope and purpose in life. We thank you for doing that. We thank you for being such a leader. A king is a leader in the society. And I'm glad that you have invited the bishop to be part of this celebration with you. in the choir here and to show him that you are the leader, because people listen to the leader. You are being such a good shepherd. If I see this big crowd here in the morning, it's because of the testimony that you are being a good shepherd, and they want to follow such a good shepherd. With my brothers, those Kazi and Elias, we were talking in the rectory before we came down, that if some of us dies, sacristy will be enough for our funeral. But if someone like Dale dies, maybe they can go to a football soccer field, you know, because of the good shepherd that you have exhibited to the people. This is the testimony. Even to see a number of priests to come for function on Saturday morning, you must give yourself credit. Because they are busy at this time in their parishes. But by the fact that they left everything and they're here with you because of your good leadership, we pray that you continue with the same spirit. Jesus tells us today, after the Jews were murmuring, how can this man claim to be? And he tells them that, look, your fathers ate the manna in the desert and they all died. But I am that bread of life. The one who partake of me will never die, will live forever. He was referring to himself. This has been the Eucharist that you have been celebrating for all these 25 years in order to give the food for eternity for the people. And that is Jesus. It has been your beautiful work of a priest to bring Jesus to the people. This is where your center of the priesthood is. That's why St. Francis once said, if he meets a priest and an angel, he will salute the priest first. Why? Because the priest is another Christ. It is the priest that brings Jesus to the people of God. You have been doing this for all these 25 years, and we are so grateful to you, my brother Dale. That is where you get your strength. That's where you get meaning to your life. Continue doing that, and you will never, never, ever go really hungry. And you will not get tired so long you continue to offer the sacrifice of the Eucharist and share it with the people of God and trust it to your own care. This is what you have been doing, and we are so grateful to you. Continue doing that, and always let the word of Mother Teresa ring in your mind. Mother Teresa always tells the priests, be only all for Jesus, be only all for Jesus. When you're for Jesus, nothing will shake you. Prophet Elijah gave up hope. He wanted to die. But the angel came and ministered to him. And after ministering to him, he continued with the journey. Know that you are not alone. Your angels who have been always with you will continue to guide you and journey with you. Always remember the word of Mother Teresa. Give yourself fully to Jesus, and always Jesus will walk with you. Never give up, because you are not alone. My dear Christians, we have all gathered here this morning to thank God for the wonderful experience of our own brother for 25 years. I know you have shown him that love for over all these years. You have embraced him. You have supported him. I ask you to continue praying for him. Continue praying for him, so that he may be truly a priest among you and continue to serve you with the word of God. He continue to lead you with his own example and continue to feed you with Jesus Christ in the Eucharist so that all of us may journey together to our way to heaven, as we are taught by our own catechism. We are here on a pilgrimage, heading to heaven, and we can only go to heaven when a priest is in our own midst to journey with us, to help us with all the sacraments. So please pray for him, and pray for all of us priests, that we may succeed amidst all the challenges that we go through. But with your prayers, with your support and love, we shall always get to the promised land.
This one is not the right.
In the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ,
and in your hands, Reverend Father Augustine Idra, Regional Superior of the Apostles of Jesus, USA region, I, Father Deogratias Rwegasira, freely, voluntarily, and with the full knowledge of my act, renew to God the vows of chastity, poverty, and obedience according to the constitutions of the Apostles of Jesus. I join my consecration to the sacrifice of Jesus to be offered as a holocaust by the Church to the Eternal Father through the intercession of the Immaculate Heart of Mary, Saint Joseph, and the Apostles of the Lord.
with confidence we have the Father with our conscience.
Our response is, Lord, have mercy on me. For the protection and strengthening of the Church, wherever she is persecuted, and that the peace of Christ will bring an end to all violent conflict in the world, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy on
me. For all civil leaders and government officials, that they may be guided by the wisdom of the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy on me.
All those who serve our country in the armed forces, that God will bless them and keep them out of harm's way. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy on me.
For all those called to priesthood and consecrated life, they will trust in Him and choose in His choice of them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy on me.
For the grace to avoid murmuring and complaining, and to live in greater awareness of God's generosity, let us pray to the Lord. For the sick, suffering, and homebound, and those who care for them, especially Frank Christoph, Andy, Mae, Amy, and Michelle, husband and daughter of Nancy Kirchner, Mary Schertz, Paula Sweeters, Claire Trumbull, Pat Fritzel, and those listed in the book of the sick, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for eternal rest and peace for all who have died, and for consolation for all those who are grieving, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for the deceased family members of Father Dale, especially for his parents, Rebellion, Guardiana Rosamond Rwegasira, for whom this mass is being offered, and for all the prayers that we hope in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Let us fast. Let those who are weak and poor hearts to hear and save them from distress. Please be close to us in our need, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
And as you look upon your Christ, who is both priest and victim, grant that I, who share in his priesthood, may always offer myself as a spiritual sacrifice pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
with your spirit. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the true eternal priest who instituted the pattern of our everlasting sacrifice and was the first to offer himself as the saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels and archangels, with the thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and the eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins, do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and confess your resurrection until you come, until you come. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with you elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Joseph, our spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Joseph and all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Ronald, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassionate, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Remember the deceased members of my family, especially my father, Reverian Rwegasira, and my mother, Verdiana Rwegasira. Grant that as they were united with your Son in death like his, they may also be one with him in his resurrection. When from the earth they will rise up in the flesh, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. And to our departed brothers and sisters too, and all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us
our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
gladden me with the chalice of the new covenant. Bring me, Holy Father, to serve you faithfully and to spend my life boldly and zealously for the salvation of all humanity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
It's certainly my privilege and great joy to speak in my own name, of course, but also in the name of my brother priests, our deacons, our religious, and the wonderful lay faithful of our diocese to say congratulations to you, Father Deogratias. What a wonderful, joyful celebration this has been, and appropriately so. I've known Father Deogratias since my days as a priest in Allentown, the Diocese of Allentown. And over these years, now as the Bishop of Harrisburg, my appreciation for him, my respect, my admiration for him has only grown richer and deeper over these years. What a great blessing it is for us to have Father and the Apostles of Jesus serving us here in our diocese. I want to thank Father Augustine Idra, certainly for being here, for his beautiful homily, but also for the commitment of the Apostles of Jesus to our diocese, to be sending and committed to send priests here to serve in our parishes and in ministries throughout our 15 counties. Father Idra, Father Augustine, thank you so very, very much for that. You know, an anniversary celebration isn't just about the passing of time. It's been 25 years since June the 30th, 1996, when Deogratias, Deacon Deogratias, became Father Deogratias. But anniversaries, this one in particular, is not just about 25 years going by, but rather over the course of those years, his fidelity, his perseverance, his relying on the grace of God to be a good, holy, self-forgetting priest. That truly is what we celebrate on an anniversary. Fidelity to the vows that you renewed this morning and your perseverance in the grace of God as another Christ. That should give us great joy. I just completed reading a book by Monsignor Stephen Rossetti, his latest, and it's called A Diary of an American Exorcist. Some of you, certainly the priests, know the name Steve Rossetti. I didn't know that he was an official exorcist. He's performed, he said, I think a few thousand exorcisms over about 20 years. One of the consistent themes in that book that struck me very, very profoundly is that Satan and the demons hate priests. This is exemplified not infrequently in the performance of an exorcism when the priest exorcist and other priests who are part of the deliverance team are verbally attacked and sometimes physically attacked by Satan and the possessing demons. Rossetti goes on to say why that is. Why do Satan and the demons hate priests? Because when they look at a priest, they see the face of Christ, whom they detest. It was a profound reminder for me of what we believe about ordination to the priesthood and what we celebrate this morning. That when a man offers himself when the church calls a man in the name of God to become ordained as into the sacred priesthood, he becomes another Christ, an alter Christus. We believe that, we teach that. The demons experience it in a way that they cannot stand. And so today, by celebrating the priesthood and congratulating and thanking God for the gift of Father Deogratias, we are lifting up that priesthood which provides for us in our spiritual lives, our sacramental lives, an alter Christus, another Christ. Father Deogratias, may God continue to bless you abundantly, and may he bless all of us abundantly through your priestly ministry. God bless you.
A small gift to give to our brother for the day on his 25th anniversary. But before we do that, I would like to take this opportunity on behalf of the Apostle Jesus Order to thank so much His Excellency Bishop Gaynor for allowing us to minister in the Diocese of Harrisburg. It has been a wonderful experience to serve the people of Harrisburg Diocese, where we are loved so much that we cannot stop thanking you, Your Excellency, for your open hearts and the arms that you have always extended to us. We pray that God may bless you and may bless the entire Diocese of Harrisburg for the support that you have given us, and we hope that this will continue for a long time. I also want to thank so much the pastor of Father Deo for organizing this event to take place today. Father, thank you so, so much. Without you, I don't think that Deo, with all his humility, will ever ask to have this celebration. So thank you, Father, and continue to support him. He has shared with us so many good things about you, and that is what it means to have a priest in the rectory. So you be assured of our own prayers as well. I have asked Father Vitus to come and present this gift to Deo on our behalf. Vitus is one of our priests who is to minister in the Diocese of Harrisburg, but he has been given a big job in our generalate. He came on his vacation and he happened to be around, so we came together this morning and asked him to come and present our small gift as a token of appreciation, and as we also congratulate Father Deo. Deo, congratulations on the 25th anniversary. Thank you for your presence.
Thank you, Father Augustine Idra. This is a certificate of blessing. We call it a papal blessing from Pope Francis from the Vatican. So thank you so much. Thank you.
And lastly, just a gentle reminder that if you are planning to attend the reception and luncheon afterwards in the hall, please move and relocate your car so that we can all exit safely. Thank you.
Before we conclude this liturgy with the final blessing, Your Excellency, Bishop Gaynor, Father Augustine, Regional Superior of the Apostles of Jesus in the United States, Father Charles, our pastor, the pastor of this church, St. Joseph's Church, my brother priest, deacons, religious men and women, my adopted parents, I'm going to introduce them, here, my niece and nephew, and my good friends, all here present. Good morning. I can still say good morning. Good morning. Thank you so much for coming. You have made my day. Your Excellency, thank you so much for taking your time in your busy schedule to be with me, you know. This humbles me very much. So thank you, Your Excellency, thank you. I would like to take this opportunity to thank God, the Almighty Father, for allowing me to participate in this ministry. And again, to thank you, all of you. Allow me also to introduce my three superiors here. Father Augustine Idra is in charge of all of us, the Apostles of Jesus in the United States. He was the homilist. Thank you, Father. Father Vidas Kaz Siriwa, as Father introduced to him, he worked here in the diocese, then he moved to Allentown Diocese later. He was promoted. Now he is representing the General Administration of the Apostles of Jesus from Nairobi, Kenya. Father Elias Munyaneza is a zonal coordinator for the Apostles of Jesus in Pennsylvania, and we used also to have some in Virginia. So, Father Elias. My adopted parents. My father died when I was a seminarian, and my mother died in 2005. That was a night after celebrating the vigil of Christmas, I received a phone call. My mother had died. Can you imagine to stay without parents? So they adopted me. They accepted me. They have been praying for me, supporting me. So they drove all the way from Massachusetts. That is Tom and Lyda Livingston. Please stand. Also, they came with Marlene Taper. Thank you so much. Please stand. I'm the youngest in the family. Our oldest brother has children, but some of them are here. Now it is Veldiana, who took the name of my mother, Ved Safari, and Irenaeus Safari. And their friend, David. They came all the way from California. I'm glad to see all of you, my friends. Some of you have not seen, we have been communicating for 10, 15 years. Just phone calls and so on, so I'm glad to see all of you here. The Knights of Columbus, thank you so much. The parishioners of St. Joseph, thank you for organizing all this, of course, Father. Again, I thank you. And the entire team. Also, the parishioners of St. Anthony's, where I lived for 2 years. Now I've been here for 4 years. Thank you so much, San Juan Bautista, St. Anne. So thank you so much. I know some have come from Shenandoah, where I started working in the core region for 4 years. I moved to Eastern Pennsylvania for 10 years where I was a pastor of Our Lady of Mercy. They are here. Thank you so much for coming. And I would like to thank the choirs. The choir. So the choir of St. Joseph's, thank you so much for your wonderful music. At the same time, I felt like I was going to heaven in an ecstasy, you know? And the choir, the Swahili choir, with the combination of the choir of those who attend the Swahili Mass here, and the Sisters of Mary Immaculate from New Jersey, thank you so much. So, and in a special way, I want to thank these choirs for accepting to sing my hymns. One of the things I could give to myself is to dedicate time and write hymns for my big occasion, so they have made it a reality. Thank you so much. I hope I did not forget anyone. And if I forgot you, please forgive me. Thank you so much. Now let us conclude and go to the next celebration. Please rise. Please bow your heads for the blessing.
May Almighty God bless you in His kindness. And pour out saving wisdom upon you. Amen. May He nourish you always with the teachings of the faith and make you persevere in good deeds.
Amen.
May He turn your steps toward Himself and show you the path of charity and peace.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth and ask them.
Amen.
St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us. We are
the best.